Hey, what is going on, guys, and welcome back to Too Much Tech. And in today's video, we're going to be checking out the Geek Customized SK64S Wireless Mechanical Optical Gaming Keyboard. This unit was provided by Banggood.com, so huge shout out to them for sending this out for review. You can get it on Banggood.com. It's about $80 right now, and there is free shipping, I believe, as well. In the US, it actually ships within like a week, too, so it ships relatively quickly if you're looking for a new gaming keyboard. This one is actually a really good option. Let's go ahead and talk about it. So first off, let's go ahead and talk about the build quality. This is a very similar case to the GK61 and the SK61 and all that stuff. This is just a really basic plastic case, but honestly speaking, the sharper edges, for some reason, the finish on this case feels a little bit better than the one on the GK61. I don't know why, but probably because it costs an average of about $20 more in terms of the base price, where the GK61 starts off around $50 to $60. So I'm glad that with that little bit of increased cost, you do get a little bit better plastic casing as well. I think it's much appreciated here. This keyboard does feature USB Type-C as well. So if you do want to use a custom cable like this, you are able to do so. So that's pretty nice as well. This one is actually from Custom Keys. He is actually running a giveaway right now for a gaming mouse on his Instagram. So I will leave a link to that giveaway in the description below and you guys can check that out. Then as far as the keycaps, these are GSA keycaps, which are a little bit flatter than, let's say, like a DSA keycap. A DSA keycap is a little bit more rounded and comes in a bit more, where the GSA keycap is kind of flat and wider. So it's pretty good. I like it a lot. It's actually very easy to hit while typing and gaming as well. So these, I'm surprised I actually like these very close to how much I like the standard profile keys. These are actually really good. And I kind of wish that more keycap vendors started making GSA keycaps. They're really nice to use. But one thing I will say about the GSA keycaps, they do have a little bit of a hollower sound. The sound is just different. Like, this is a PBT keycap as well, but it's just, it seems kind of hollow, but not in a bad way, but just different. Then in terms of the color options, there are three. The unit that I went with was the white with red legends and pink and green accents. Then there's also a black, gray, and red one. And then there's like a white, gray, and red one as well. A few different color options. And then you can also choose between a variety of different optical switches. So this time around, I decided to go with the optical reds. I do have a GK61, actually two of them, and one that has optical yellows and one that has optical silvers. Now, between the switch options on the SK64S, they have browns, blacks, blues, and reds. Obviously, out of those, I'm gonna go with the best case scenario. I'm gonna pick the red switches because the rest of them, the blacks have too heavy of a spring for my liking, and the blues, I don't like blues, no thank you. Brown switches are pretty decent as well, so between the two switch options, I would go with either the browns if you want tactile or the reds if you want linear. Now, in terms of the optical performance, very, very good. Like, very quick actuation. If you want, you can like half press the keys and, you know, actuate the keys really, really quick, especially if you play like Fortnite or something like that. This will definitely come in handy. Now, a lot faster than like a standard mechanical keyboard, I wouldn't really say it's a lot faster, but in games like Fortnite that have fantastic inputs that you can hit a million keys at once and it registers all the inputs, that can actually be pretty valuable, having very fast key switches. So this is something that you will notice. This keyboard does feature RGB lighting as well. And I did mention that it was wireless. To turn it on, all you do is hold the function 2 key and the tab key. You'll still see a little Dragon Ball S animation happen on the keyboard and it will come to life. But to set up your different Bluetooth profiles, you're gonna wanna hit function 2, Z, X, or C to switch between your three different profiles. But to initially set up the profile, you have to hold either Z, X, or C while holding the function 2 key. To lock the Windows key, you press and hold the menu key or function 2 and press the Windows key, and that will lock your Windows key. Then to change your RGB lighting, you're gonna press and hold the function key, and then there's a lot of keys on this area. So this will either turn on and off the backlight, this will switch between the different RGB modes, and then you got your brightness controls here on your up and down area, arrows, and the speed of the effect as well. And that's pretty much all you'll need in terms of controls. There is software that you can download for the SK64S. Basically, it's the same software that you use to control any of the other Geek Customized or EpoMaker keyboards as well. And basically in there, you control the RGB, you can set up the layers and all that stuff. And that's pretty much it. It's not the easiest software to use, but it's definitely doable. Just takes a little bit to get used to it. In terms of the battery life, it has a 1900 milliamp hour battery. I plugged it in. It's actually dead right now, but typically with RGB on full brightness, it lasts me about 4 days of use, about 4 to 6 hours each day. So that will put it right between 20 to 24 hours of battery life with the RGB lights on. If you do happen to run across some Gateron optical yellows and you want to pop them in, you are able to. I highly recommend like spray lubing any optical switches that you get because it just makes them sound so much better. I like the spring weight and the sound of Gateron yellows as well. So even if you start off with the reds and at some point you want to upgrade to the yellows, I highly recommend it. They are very good and they sound a little bit better than the Gateron reds. But overall, I mean the unique form factor of the SK64S being the 65% layout, that having the shift key and the delete button in this very small compact form factor, I actually like that quite a bit. Now I will say, typing wise, this shift key is not really the most ergonomic, but I'm almost willing to give that up. Honestly speaking, I kind of wish that this shift key was two units and then we just had the up arrow here and then I could just press shift and like maybe backspace or something like that to activate the delete key. But that's not really the way that it is. It is not really the end of the world, but it would have been nice to see because I feel like it would have been a little bit easier to use typing wise. But overall, it's something that you can get used to. And if you're buying this layout, you probably expect to as well. So it's pretty unique. I think that it looks good, and I think that Geek Customize did a good job. A somewhat unique casing for this one that does feel a little bit, just a little bit more premium than your standard GK61. But alright guys, that is going to be it for this video. If you guys enjoyed, be sure to drop a like and subscribe if you guys are new to the channel. Huge shout out to Banga.com for sending over this keyboard as well. It is, like I said, only $80 for a wireless keyboard. And I do think that this is a really good competitor to the AM Pro 2 as well for a similar price. So I would definitely pick this up. In my opinion, this has better keycaps than the AM Pro 2 stock. But thank you guys once again for tuning in. If you got any questions, feel free to drop them in the comment section below or join my Discord channel as well. I will see you guys in the next video.